Former Wallabies coach Eddie Jones has apologised to Aussie fans after jumping ship to coach the Japan's national rugby team despite repeatedly denying links with the Japanese Rugby Federation. Take a listen.
The first interview I had with Japan was in December. I gave everything I could for that short period of time and it wasn't good enough. As we spoke about before, I had a plan of what we needed to do to change Australian rugby and we weren't able to do that. Rugby Australia weren't able to help support that.
OK, The Age and Sydney Morning Herald sports reporter Tom Decent joins us now live from Tokyo. Tom, good morning to you once again. He insists his first job interview was just last week. Do you buy it?
Not particularly. It's pretty interesting. The Zoom invitation link for that meeting that Eddie jumped on actually says first round interview, JRFU, Eddie Jones. So the Sydney Morning Herald on The Age beg to differ on that one.
Look, he did, we should point out, he did make an apology to Wallabies fans for falling short during that press conference. However, he did also deflect suggestions that he is disloyal. How do you think fans are going to read that?
Yeah, I'm not too sure. I don't think the public sentiment is too great for Eddie Jones at the moment. They're still very clearly upset at the World Cup results and also reports that he was speaking to Japan before the World Cup. So, yeah, I think Wallabies fans are happy to leave Eddie Jones to be Japan coach and maybe not see him for a little while.
I mean, some people, you know, former friends, they've also gotten stuck into him. I think Sonny Bill Williams labelled him a disgrace. Do you think that's a fair call?
Look, that's Sonny words, but yeah, clearly I've spoken to a lot of Wallabies players who were led to believe in the Eddie Jones dream and to stick with him on this long-term vision till 2027. And he's quit while the going's got tough. So, there are privately some players that are very upset at this disappointment and believe that Eddie had, his best intentions at heart and to stick around with Australia long-term.
All right, well, let's take a bit of a positive note now. What do you think the general mood is about his future when it comes to the Japanese press, about his appointment?
I would say it's a mixture. Like, clearly Eddie Jones is a bit of a hero over here, given his results before with Japan, but there's a bit of conjecture amongst Japanese media whether the president, Toshida-san, has already given Eddie the job behind closed doors and that this was a bit of a flawed appointment. So very mixed over here and certainly an interesting press conference last night, that's for sure.
Yeah.